Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. In the last video, I shared what it was like living with Windows on ARM for a year, and also talked about what my ideal next Windows on ARM laptop would be, which I was pretty sure to be a ThinkPad at that time. Well, that didn't really age well, because today, I just received my new Microsoft Surface Pro 11 tablet. And less than 2 hours after getting it and installing a tempered glass screen protector, we're putting a new SSD in, so let's get stuck in. Here are the things that you need to change the SSD in the Microsoft Surface Pro. Depending on how crazy you go with the SSD, this job can range anywhere between $80 and over $200. In my case, it's about $230 or $240, but that's because I opted for a 2TB SSD. However you slice it, it's still way less than what Microsoft wants for a 1TB hard drive. So we have a tiny Torx screwdriver, a phase change thermal pad kit for the new SSD, a 32GB flash drive to serve as our recovery disk, and the SSD itself. The Torx screwdriver that we're going to be using today is a size 3, but even then, there's still a little play when you use it on the screw that comes in the Surface Pro. And that's because the star pattern on the Surface Pro screw is a little wider than the star pattern that comes with the screwdriver, so you'll have to be very careful when you use it to remove the screw. For the hard drive, I chose to go with the Corsair Mini MP600, not to be confused with the Corsair Core Mini MP600, which is a QLC-based drive. This one's a TLC, so I don't think it's going to be the fastest, but in terms of use life, this one's 600 TBW, which means it should serve me for many, many years to come. It's a single-sided M.2 2230 drive, and as you can see on the underside, it's made in Taiwan. I bought everything I'm going to use today from Amazon, and I'll include the links in the description below. Moving on to the thermal pad and heatsink kit, we have screws which we will not use, a copper heatsink, and a bunch of thermal pads in different sizes which we will use, some sort of thumb pressure applicator, a screwdriver in the wrong size, as well as a spatula or pry tool. Before anything else, you'd want to create the recovery drives since the Surface Pro uses a special disk image with hardware-specific apps. So you'll do just that by opening the start menu and typing create a recovery drive, click on that, and then just follow the on-screen instructions. Once you're done, you'll notice that there are only two folders in your recovery drive because what you have just created is just that, a recovery drive that boots but doesn't have any data that it can use for recovery. So download the Surface Pro specific Windows recovery image from the Microsoft site. I'll have a link for that in the description below. And once you're done, extract the contents of that into your recovery drive and you're good to go. Now, onto the hardware. The copper heatsink has protective plastic on both sides, so remove them first. Do a test fit with the SSD just to make sure everything snaps on properly. Inspect the gaps between the heatsink and the chips on the SSD just to make sure that they are even and minimal. Once verified, remove the heatsink so you can start prepping the SSD with the thermal pads. Carefully remove the protective plastic on one side of this green thermal pad first. Based on the seller's listing on Amazon, this piece goes on the chips closer to the PCIe socket. Carefully tamp it down to secure it, and then remove the protective plastic on the other side. The rest of the surface area can be covered by this bigger piece right here, so do the same thing. Align it carefully, tamp it down, and then remove the liner on the other side. Install the copper heatsink and make sure it snaps into place. I did notice a little lift on one edge, but after inspecting the space between the heatsink and the chips, or lack thereof, everything seems to be in order. Can't be too careful though, so I tamped it down with the included thumb press. Time to move on to drive replacement. Microsoft makes it really easy for you to replace the SSD, so with the kickstand open and the tablet facing down, press down on the indent, and then lift the lid up to remove it. Once you have the lid off, grab the Torx screwdriver and very carefully remove the screw holding the SSD in place. Like I said earlier, the Torx 3 size is ever so slightly loose, so you want to apply firm downward pressure as you do this. Once that's done, pry the drive up and wiggle it out. Notice here that the hard drive that Microsoft supplied also has its own heatsink. Now grab the drive that we just prepped and slide it in the PCIe slot. Take care to make sure that it's fully in there before you press down on it. Grab the screwdriver and screw and tighten it down. Again, apply firm downward pressure while you're doing this to make sure that the screwdriver doesn't slip out of the screw head. Once you have the drive in place, slide the lid back in, and the magnet should take it home. Now that we have the physical drive out of the way, it's time to initiate recovery. Plug the recovery drive in, followed by a charger. A USB-C charger is totally fine here. Hold the power and volume down buttons at the same time until the Windows logo appears. Select your language and keyboard layout, and then recover from drive. Another screen will pop up after that. In this case, I chose just remove my files for a quick format. One final confirmation and it'll start copying files from your recovery drive to the SSD. This process will take a while, so give it some time. I sped it up to 4x playing speed just to save your time here. For a seamless recovery process, you'd also want to make sure that you have Wi-Fi readily accessible, since Windows 11 needs internet access for a complete recovery process. It'll reboot a couple times and then you'll get to this Getting Devices Ready screen. Again, just give it some time. At this point, it's probably already using the files that it copied to the hard drive, but still keep the recovery drive plugged in to be safe. Once you get past this welcome message and onto the light colored screens, you're pretty much good to go, so you can now unplug the recovery drive to avoid boot loops. Just follow the on-screen setup instructions and you're all set. And there you have it, SSD upgrade on the Microsoft Surface Pro 11. If you found this video useful, please do consider subscribing. Thank you for watching, I'll see you next time.